So back in June, when ministers announced new flexible working laws, in fact now all UK employees are allowed to use flexible working, we conducted research for 500 people in the UK, 500 people in Germany, to find out if they had the right tools and conditions to allow them to do remote working, but at the same time protect the information they were taking out from their corporate offices. So we uncovered some concerning findings regarding employees' attitudes towards remote working and their awareness of data security when taking work out from the workplace. So over a third of those we interviewed did not actually feel that, or rather felt that the responsibility for protecting data wasn't actually theirs. And over a third also were aware of either colleagues or individuals or even themselves having lost data whilst they were remote working. So as many as three quarters of respondents were actually taking digital files out from the workplace to work on, 36% on laptops, 33% on USB devices. However, a lot of the information they were taking out on these devices was not encrypted and was not password protected, therefore leaving the organisation open to data breaches and some real security problems. So when questioning these workers, 41% said that the company they work for, the entity they work for, did not have the right security tools for them to work remotely, and 27% said that they didn't feel that the entity they work for had the right security policies in place. The worrying thing we found was many office workers were not actually concerned about any security breaches that might happen as a result of remote working. In fact, on questioning, only 1 in 16 said that they felt that they should worry about work that they took out of the office. Nearly half, in fact 44%, said that data they take outside the office is very rarely encrypted, in fact is never encrypted. And 3 out of 10 people don't even bother with password protection. This relaxed attitude was further amplified by other statistics, other findings that we had. So losing devices in a public place, almost a third admitted to losing a device in a public place. And of those devices that were lost, three quarters of the missing laptops, mobile phones, USB devices, USB sticks, they all contained work-related data. Confidential emails, 37% of the time. Files, 34% of the time. Customer data, 21% of the time. These are truly shocking figures. So worryingly, some employees are so determined to work outside of office hours, either to complete their working day or because it's a more comfortable environment to work in, that actually a quarter of them will either knowingly or unknowingly break company rules on remote working so that they can remote work. In fact, also what was worrying was even though 61% of people would inform their bosses if there was a data breach or rather a data loss on a device they were using, you know, 1 in 10 would hide this truth. And a lot of the respondents actually did not know who within the company they should report the data loss to anyway. So it shows there's a fundamental lack of security rules and regulations understood by the company employees. They may have these in place, but it's the understanding. And I think that's what companies need to look to. So on the whole, businesses seem to be failing to provide secure tools for remote working. In fact, 79% of respondents to our survey read and write emails, and 69% work on digital files outside of the office. However, 41% say they don't have either the right tools or feel their tools could be improved. And what was very interesting about this was even though over 80% of our respondents, approximately 85% of our respondents, didn't work in IT, we also had a number of respondents, approximately 11%, who did work in IT security. And even though they felt they had the right tools, a lot of them still felt the tools could be improved and perhaps weren't quite good enough. So the focus on protecting data whilst working on the move varied by industry sector. What was interesting was the finance sector was easily the best prepared. Three quarters of them had a remote working policy in place. If you compare that to such bodies as charity workers, retail distribution, transport, less than half had a remote working policy in place. But what's more worrying about this though is the fact that when you go back to the finance sector who had these policies in place, actually 12%, the highest level of any workforce, 12% were actually knowingly breaking their remote working policies. So this brings up the question, is having a remote working policy and strictly trying to get your staff to adhere to it, is it enough to ask them to do it, or does there need to be a way of forcing them to do it? Because people will always take the easiest option. And if that means breaking the remote working policy, that can sometimes be the case. Financial implications of data loss can be catastrophic. If you think about the rules and regulations that have come out of the Brussels over the last 5 years, if you look at the way the fines that are imposed on people for losing data have increased, I mean, now the ICO can fine up to £500,000 for loss of data. But if also you look at the implications of you as a company, if you are in the press for losing data, if you're in the press for losing information about your clients, are those clients really going to stay with you? Or are they going to look for an alternative, supposedly more secure bank or financial institution in which to put their money? So even though you might think that your data breach or your data loss has occurred today, what you've got to remember is that loss could actually have implications for years to come. So although most employees realize there is a security need to keep data secure whilst remote working, with in fact 1 in 5 workers actually providing their own security levels, companies need to look at, are they providing the right encryption? You know, have they weighed up the difference between software encryption and hardware encryption? Have they looked at USB encryption? Have they looked at security levels on USB devices, on laptops? Are they providing the right policies? And also very important, are they providing the right security training for staff before they let their staff leave the office with confidential data?